super brutal, and I don't see how this one is going to be any different. We're desperately trying to level up our soldiers to get spot side increases. As it stands, we're still down and have only 5 guys here. And we haven't even gotten any weapon upgrades so far. So things are rather looking dire. Gentlemen, it is time to kick some alien ass and chew bubblegum. We know that there's a tower here, so all of this here will be overside. These little circles here already indicate that there is probably going to be a tower-ish structure. We can't get up here because we don't have a grappling hook. This here is high ground, but pretty far in the back. Pretty far in the back. So I'm not sure if we want to do that, actually.
On my way.
There's a civilian. One of these assholes who's going to shout XCOM, XCOM when we're going to be near them. And we need to... we need to definitely kill this object. So what I'm going to try here, guys, is we're going to line up here, alright? And we're going to try to blow a hole into the wall, fight whatever is there, and try to get rid of the objective. And on top of doing that, I am proposing we're taking the high ground here for now with Sis Withered, and with steady weapon we might even be able to take a couple of shots without completely sucking. Alright, Roby's on the prowl here, he's following, and Ansa's trail certainly is as well. We have a good team, big names here on this squad. So hopefully they can fulfill the expectations that fans are putting into them. Fans are expecting that they are going to perform well. But they also expected it from Arnold last mission. Arnold was the VIP of Season 4. And he just got killed on a mission. That's pretty sad.
Headed there now.
This probably is by far the bloodiest run that I've ran so far, and by bloody I don't mean the insulting English expression, I actually mean like
solid copy,
the most bloodshed run I have had so far. Very intense. Squad side minus 30, so we do have effectively minus 10 from range, 20 from being up high, and 30 for kind of being too far away. But that's okay for me. I don't mind yet.
Orders confirmed. Moving out.
Alright, these guys are probably going to force us. Yeah, we are stuck here. We are definitely stuck here.
Heading out.
1, 2, 3. She can see more than that. Oh no, it's 6. Really? 6 guys? Are you kidding me? You must be out of your mind, guys. Well, the rocket itself deals a lot of damage, more than the normal grenade would. And I feel that dealing 4 damage to 6 enemies at the same time is a worthwhile start. So we are not too far away from this target, not too far. And we will need to engage because these fuckers will go here next turn anyways. So how about we start with a big bang
catch!
Good lord, that was actually pretty, pretty solid hit. I'm positively impressed. Yeah, of course. The lances are taking lancing positions. I wouldn't have expected anything else to happen here. Question with the grenades is, could we kill? So if we go like this here, well, we're probably going to remove our own cover. That doesn't sound like a wise idea. It doesn't only sound like a wise idea, that's a fucking stupid idea. Let's be real. But this here would remove a lot of the cover, and it would give us the option, it would kill two of them. And it would remove a lot of the cover, and we need a lot of kills at the moment. That's our main problem, we don't have enough turns to kill all of them.
They have been destroyed.
Good. Half of the bus station is gone. The other half is still standing. So let's see. We do have a 100% shot on him. Probably are going to kill him. Not going to kill him? Yeah, let's take the 100% chance and hopefully we kill him. Come on, Sis Withered. Good job, man. Good job. He just obliterated that Star Lancer. This time it starts working out better and better. Ancestral here. How are we going to deal with him? Fifty-fifty on the Stun Lancer. And Ancestral has the other option to do something. Like what we could do in terms of like being productive here is the Advent Priest is going to heal as a primary target and the Sun Lance is going to approach at us anyways. So how about we move here with his shotgun and just do shotgun to the face. So yeah, I think that was the right decision because the Advent officer still had a grenade and I don't like that at all. So we could either go for 50-50 and deal some damage, or we take the 8 protocol. I think we're going aggressive here and just try our shot. Good job, Warnai. You hit him well, but unfortunately not enough damage. Yeah, now Lance has got a Lance. And they always go for whatever reason, they always go for the healer. Like, it's in their DNA, they do want to kill the healers so bad.
Sure.
Yeah, fuck you for healing this guy.
I'm on it. Target eliminated.
No, we're not using the sniper here. I would propose really to try. If I knew that this here wouldn't trigger, I definitely would take the move. I probably will still take the move because we only have 6 more turns left.
Advent troops here.
Yeah, that's not too much of an issue. We are in full cover for now. And I rather prefer to launch a grenade there and like use the explosion of the car to kill some. Yeah, that is probably a very, very good idea. Here we go.
Get ready for surprise!
Roby, my man, takes yet another grenade. Wow, Beautiful. Beautiful. That's how I define beauty, Roby style. He went there, he went all in, and he killed them.
On your order.
Larkonk taking yet another shot. Very, very solid. 50-50 to kill the Advent Priest. Yep. 50-50 doesn't mean it's an automatic hit, as we have just seen. Why exactly can't we heal ourselves? Oh, we are disoriented. Great. Wonderful. So yeah, Vorna is gonna go into full cover. She's not going to hit anything anyways with being disoriented, so half cover is just as good as taking Overwatch shots. Yeah, I wasn't expecting that this is actually going to hit. But we killed a lot of them. Four guys down in one turn. That first grenade of Roby was really, really, really instrumental for us.
Incoming over here.
And as long as we keep pushing now, we should be fine. That's already the second pack that we encounter. Don't you dare shooting at Vornai, fuck you. Wow, Lancer. Lancer's got a lance and he's missing.
There's heavy fire in this zone!
I'm doing something.
Alright, Vornai is still disoriented, so no healing for her. I think we need to move the sniper next turn. I mean, that's just not going to work out. We could explode the tank here and kill the Advent Priest, and I think we're going to go for that one. So Blarkong reloading.
Back in.
And blowing up the tank. Which then just killed this guy. So pretty good. Let's use the time to reload. We don't want to trigger another pack. We still need to finish this one off. And I really like how holo targeting is making your life easier here. Like this guy here now has a significant problem because he's holo targeted and is standing in the open. So even Vornai with her disorientation of minus 25, holo targeting, flanking him. Like, that's still a pretty solid shot. And she's going for the kill. Good job, Vornai. Good fucking job. Should have used Blarkong to actually suppress him, which would have been the smarter move. Roby doesn't have suppression. Roby has just the option to kill. That's not looking like a good shot here in full cover. So we're going to go for Overwatch, and we are going to move our sniper, which will now take us two turns to effectively go there. But yeah, not being able to shoot with the sniper is even worse. Oh, good job, Roby. Good fucking job. So, I would propose that we're going closer here, and we know that there is the option.
I'm on it.
So let's just position ourselves here, a little bit more clever. just a little bit closer. We're steadying the weapons.
On your order. Scanning.
Arriva.
On overwatch.
Get up and get back out there.
Good. The reason why I was so defensive in this turn is I wanted to get everyone on the same.
Bring in reinforcements.
On this, oh wow, reinforcements? Are you kidding me? Okay, we need to try take out the target this turn, and then we can go for reinforcements.
On your order.
Okay, let's try to scout here.
We've got the objective in sight.
Good. Roby's taking a shot. Good man. You can definitely rely on Roby. I mean, that's a given fact. This guy definitely knows what he's doing.
Eliminate any remaining hostiles and move to evac.
Okay, but we need to now take care about this situation here. And by this situation, I unfortunately mean the little invasion that is going to occur in any second.
Overwatch.
Moving to position.
Alright, shotgun overwatch, that's good.
Head now.
Just want to go a little bit closer. When they land, they don't have a chance to immediately shoot at us. That's the difference to the normal overwatch, to the normal packs that you're triggering. They cannot immediately shoot. Or at least I've never seen them immediately shoot. And I've had a lot of reinforcements in our career here. But we can take four overwatch shots. And hopefully we're going to kill some of them. Alright, one guy down, and the captain is down. That's not too bad. That's not too bad. I think it was a pair of five, and we killed two. That's actually already pretty good. So, Blarkong is going to move up here. Just want to make sure that we can really rely on killing these guys. Good job, Blarkong. Good fucking job. Well, that unfortunately was not such a good job. Let's give our Sis Withered here the 8 protocol, just to make sure that in case he's gonna be the target, he's not gonna be fully flanked. Bornite deals a little bit of damage. I'm not sure if this is going to be sufficient enough in order to kill this guy. Probably we're not going to get close enough to actually deal damage. No, we aren't. Roby is too far away.
Moving to position.
No, Roby's too far away. An Ancestral here. I mean,
I'm on it.
He's definitely gonna go shotgun to the face, and that's about it. But there's one guy left, and he's gonna take some shot. That's for sure. Well, we can take an overwatch, and maybe he moves. But maybe he just takes a shot. Lucky for us, we took the 8 protocol. Question from the chat, how much damage is the explosion of the car? A normal car deals 6 points of damage, a truck in this size here deals 8, and there are really giant trucks which deal 10. So it depends on the size of the car, and yeah, it's a very, very nice way to up your damage. So using explosive trucks or blowing them up effectively increases your DPS quite substantially. That's the reason why we're using it. because we are abusing all of the mechanisms available for us.
Ya estoy.
Ready to go.
We're stabilizing the weapons just to increase steady the weapon just to increase our aiming percentage here. I am proposing to move up here. Darkhawk needs to reload as well. We're no longer having a timer because we just need to kill the last pack. And we already know, I mean you guys know it as good as I do, that the last pack is back there where the final objective was. Because the one guy that we have injured but not killed was running into this direction. So the game already told us where the last pack is, so to speak.
Scanning. On the move. On the move.
Good, let's just stabilize here and make sure everyone's okay. And next turn we can then start to motor. We haven't had any injuries that have not been treated, so everyone's healed up. That's fine.
I'm on it.
On your order.
On your order. Come get some.
I'm moving before I'm ending the turn, always. Overwatch. Just to play very carefully here. In case we're triggering something, we still have all of the actions left of all of our guys.
Moving to position.
Moving to position.
We are starting to get a little bit closer.
Overwatch.
And I am waiting finally to trigger them, but it seems to be difficult. They are very shy for whatever reason.
On the move. On the move. On the move.
On the move.
Espero que valga la pena.
On overwatch. Come get some.
Scanning.
Still nothing triggered. That's interesting.
I'm on it.
Let's see, this one here should trigger something.
I've got eyes on advent troops.
Yeah, I was pretty sure it would. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have an advent priest, 2 stun lances, 2 normal troopers, a third normal trooper who's injured, and a sectoid. That's pretty large pack. Yeah, but we're not going to use explosives here. That would be a little bit suicidal. I have the distinct feeling that we will miss our shots, and I don't want to be in that situation. Okay, so what's a positive or good place to hide? Maybe we need to fall back yet a little bit more.
On your order.
What I'm probably going to do. Ancestrayer could get out of line of sight. Like over here. So they are forced to move towards our position. And let's use our steadied weapon here. Wow, that was 4 but not 5 damage. So bad. Overwatch. We could move over here into full cover. another Overwatch, and yet one more Overwatch. So when they are actually moving, we will get three gratis shots. And we get a 14 hit points zombie. Why not? Super convenient zombie. First Overwatch shot misses. Second one hits. And third one hits plus kills the stun lancer. So that was actually a pretty good Overwatch shot. I like it. Ancestray is now taking some more damage. The wall here is broken. I haven't seen that before I took the turn. Otherwise, I wouldn't have moved him there. Don't dare to kill him. Okay, we're pretty much okay for now. We just need to make sure that we take the right decisions now. That one here would be interesting, but I think it's not clever to use the rocket. It's too unprecise, and the chance of actually killing ourselves is too high. We could move up to here, which will trigger Overwatch and will not give us any line of sight. Ancestral himself does have 90% Overwatch avoidance, and if we move him over here, he would be in full cover. He could then throw a grenade here and completely blind everyone. That's a good one. Yeah, he has lightning reflexes, so Overwatch shots ain't got shit on him. Now let's use the flashbang here. I want to make sure that we get the four in the background. Oh, we can even get five. That's a good trade.
Need a light?
It will automatically kill the zombie here as well, because the sectoid is flashbanged, and now we can basically start to finish them one by one. Sectoid wouldn't be a bad target. Wow, nice little crit. Sis withered, nice little crit. Our gunner has enough hit points to take a couple of blows if that would be needed. Let's see, if we would take the rocket. Wow, shooting the rocket now is not a good idea. So instead, let's just try to kill the sector. Perfect. Lovely shot. So if we're moving over here, we have no line of sight on anyone. That's really bad. Could move all the way here. That would be okay. This here would be okay. But I'm fearing that this guy can move around here and will then just flank Roby. That's not a good idea, really. Let's move Warnai up here. She's still healthy enough in case someone would take a shot. The Advent Priest flanking is really good, but she doesn't deal enough damage, unfortunately. And since we have so many guys in half cover, we might as well take Roby into half cover and try to finish one of these guys off. And unfortunately didn't work, but most of them are disoriented, so we are going to be fine. I hope so. Yeah, disorientation into full cover. That's not going to work out, bro. Like I said, disorientation into full cover is not going to work out, bro. Normal shots into full cover also not working out. You guys need to train a little bit more. Why are they even all... Why are all of them shooting into full cover? That's super stupid. Like, with disorientation and full cover, their chances to hit is less than 5%. And still they take the shots, instead of just shooting into half cover. That's a really stupid move of the AI.
On the move. Come on, get back in the fight!
Just because they were thinking that they could one-shot him, doesn't mean that they actually can do that. So yeah, not very smart usage of the AI here, to be honest.
Tiro desviado.
I wish we could go a little bit more aggressive here. This guy back here has a pretty nice position to flank us, so probably not going to work out all too well. Like, flanking around the corner definitely would be an option. This here could be a thing, but I don't know. Since it's the last pack, let's just try to legitimately kill these two guys. Yeah, it was just one kill though, so not the best usage. Could have been more efficient. We could go here and just flank him, but in reality the star monster will just move up and then probably kill us. We could go here though. The problem that I do have is that the damage is not guaranteed. Like, his damage is 4-6, and even with a high crit chance, there is still a probability that he's going to survive. Literally just shot him down to 1 HP, but he still is surviving. So yeah, standing into full cover instead is the smarter move.
They're all over me.
Although these guys are now... Yeah, now they're going for half cover. They're trying to take a shit on us. I don't fear that because he has lightning reflexes, so the shot was neglectable.
Hostile target down.
And it was 100% chance to get rid of the Overwatch. So what are we going to do here? I would suppose we're going to move up.
Location confirmed.
Just want to try to set up a flank now. And let's move everyone into full cover, really. Stabilize the weapon. We will give our scout, who is in half cover, full cover. So everyone's now in full cover. And we'll just wait until the end of the round, I suppose. These two have pretty decent positions, but the AI... they even needed to reload, like super idiotic to reload there.
I got nothing. I need a medic.
And yet another critical strike. Good job, buddy. All right, Roby is going over here and is starting to teach this guy manners. 100% shot into his back. Shredded him, also gave him some really, really nice damage. 100%. And the kill.
Hostile terminated.
Good job. Ansys Trail moves up. And I think you guys know what time it is. It is shotgun to the face time. 100%. Down he goes.
Yep. X-ray neutralized.
We did it. We did it. And I am very happy that the mission went so smooth.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
So, Operation Half Eaten Heat was a success. We got long drawn out firefights. Almost exclusively were on higher numbers this time, and our grenades really did a good job for us, so I'm pretty happy with that. We exploded the core, which helped us, and we used all of the grenades. So yeah, Bransky, cheer up. That was really good, guys. Really, really good. I like it. If you want your drop down, you gotta send the A-team. That's what you need to do. Roby just got his promotion. And I am... guys, I'm serious. I know that you're probably going to laugh, but I'm taking demolition here. Because, like I said, I installed a mod which is fixing demolition, and I want to see if the mod is as good as the author described it. If it's any good, then demolition is definitely a thing to consider. Wow, we just got a new hidden ability. Battle Scanner. Battle Scanner provides extra visions on the battlefield. Soldiers to deploy it like grenades, throwing it into hidden areas, so she got the extra permanent ability to throw down battle scanners from the AWC. I think that's pretty good. Warnai, consider yourself lucky. Sis Withered, Long Watch all the way. And we got Blarcomb. And we can either take Rapid Reaction Fire if on Overwatch, confers a reaction shot for every every reaction shot that hits. So that's the better variant of Guardian. Fire in the hole, grants plus 10 aim and 3 range for rockets if the soldier has not moved this turn. I like the idea of rapid reaction because I really like Guardian. That's a positive thing on rapid reaction. But I mean, that's a Grenadier, and I would want to build around the grenades also a little bit. So we're going to go fire in the hole here. Good. A lot of corpses, that's for sure. Advent Priest Autopsy. Psionically powerful, and instead of using their Psy abilities for destruction, the priest uses the Psy energy to aid their allies.
Hello, Commander.
And we got ourselves 170 supplies. Good job, gentlemen. Good job. If we look at our queue, by the way, only 14 more days to magnetic weapons, and maybe, just maybe, we are going to survive that. I am not sure, because it still looks like shit for us. If I'm looking at the availability, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 guys available. That's not a lot. Rookies, yeah, probably rookies are not bad because we need more freshmen.
Avenger plotting new course.
This is Longwar, and the game seems to know exactly what we need. Lots and lots of potential soldiers. Look at that, we got ourselves another gunner. Ozodis just joined the team. Welcome, dude. Welcome to the team. Nice little black fellow here. Two gunners, one grenadier, ranger, rocketeer, two scouts, sharpshooters. Fire Wolfie, I would want to train you in order to become yet another ranger or a grenadier. I think ranger is more fitting though, so we hopefully will get some more diversity in our ranks. So yeah, ranger it is. And look at that, we got ourselves another 80 loot.
Maximum power consumption reached.
Proving rounds definitely would be helpful, but we can't afford to do them at the moment. We need to wait for the power relay to finish. And I think in the meantime we can do yet another excavation here. We'll take 30 days, but that's fine. We're not in a rush, we don't need to hurry too much. In terms of upgrading the offices, the Guerrilla Tactic School, that's not going to work out. We don't have the necessary power either. We could go for only crappy upgrades. We could go for wet work to get faster experience. But honestly, I'm pretty happy with the 400 supplies that we do have. I want to really go for magnetic weapons once they are available. So we need to save some money. I have increased the cost of magnetic weapons drastically, so you will see. Wow, 4 rookies, that's not bad, guys. Look at that, we got some freshmen here. So we got Zapek here, who you saw, you have been drafted, man. JHP Hemswise and Blue. Yep, not too bad. Still got rooks for more training. We got 70 info, we still need more, so I'm going to farm for more info here.
Western United States.
And then we make the contact.
Commander, the aliens
should have probably edited the Avatar project as well to be a little bit slower.
We're going to slow them down, we'll need to move fast.
Oh.
Commander, remote reconnaissance indicates the aliens have a UFO hunting for our position. We need to be careful about where we pick our flight path.
Yep, and there is Operation Warfall.
Setting course for
so no more scanning for
Eastern
intel.
United
it's
States.
Time for retaliation mission. Wow. Look at that, we have a lot of shaken characters. So, we got ourselves one support, one sniper. One gunner here, young Skywalker, is shaken, but we can take him on the mission. We're taking LOD Roby as well. Need some strong grenades here. So we got grenades, gunner, sharpshooter. Now we just need someone for the front line. And we either take a scout, which I think is going to be the better option here. Yeah, let's take a scout and really take a good team here. We need to be successful on some of these missions, otherwise this is going to look pretty dumb. We haven't researched the sector so far. So I'm not really sure how this one is going to work out. We will need to see. We have a couple of guys with low will. And we need to see how the C1 is going to work out. Like, probably I'm going for a second flashbang grenade here. So our sniper now has also the option to flashbang, which is not too bad. We could use battle scanners. Well, do we have Warneye? Because she has battle scanners. She got it as the perk. No, she's still lightly wounded. That's bad. We could have really used that because they are going to be faceless ones and they are going to be very, very, very annoying. So yeah, he's going to be our frontline fighter together with Ancestral. And I'm actually thinking about taking away this grenade and instead giving Ancestral some more hit points. 6 is probably not really good enough. I'm not going to take any of the other Wests because we haven't yet researched them and I don't want to build it right away. That would be cheating. We only have nanoscale Wests so far. That's the only thing that we do have. So might as well build that. Okay, so that's okay. We do have two frontline tanks, these two guys, and the rest should be a little bit more in the background. We don't have any weapon modifications other than the sniper. So let's give him the upgraded sniper. But I can't remember that we had any other weapons. We lost really every weapon upgrade in this stupid VIP mission. So yeah, that's it. Two frontline tanks, two grenades, and some other stuff. Good, here we go, guys. Here we go. Tetris mentions that we have two bad dark events at once. That's correct, Matt. We certainly have two bad dark events. But when you're a regular viewer, you will see that I only get bad events. For some reason, we are not pretty fortunate.
Contacts in the resistance says Advent peacekeepers have been spotted conducting a sweep.
All right, welcome everyone
to
Operation Warfall. It is the second retaliation mission in